As we transition to the Lord's Supper, let us pray. Father, the words of the ancient hymn still resonate in our hearts. We pray that you would be our vision in all that we do, our central focus of life. Our eyes would be upon you in all that we do, that we live this life not for just gain, that all we've gained be count for nothing but what we've done for Christ. Father, reflect upon the immense gift of your Son giving himself for us, spread eagle on cross beams on the town garbage heap just outside Jerusalem, dying not to save himself, but to those who come after him in faith, dying for his bride. Father, remind us, as the writer of Hebrews said, that every year, priests stand in place of sacrifice, offering sacrifices first for their sins, and then again and again, year after year, bulls, rams. Father, remind us that Christ, who sacrificed himself, died not for his sins, but for ours. That his sacrifice is not to be repeated, as he is the perfect Lamb of God. And Father, now as we transition to worship of you through preaching, now to worship of you through the elements of this sacrament, of this supper. Father, help us to be so focused on the sacrifice of Christ that we see ourselves as for the sinners who we truly are, unworthy, undeserving of your grace, but free recipients. For it is in Christ we pray. And everyone says, amen. I would ask Brother David and Jeremy to come down to serve the Lord's Supper at this time. I'll be reading, as always, from the Gospel of Matthew, Matthew chapter 26, reading verses 26 through 29. And now as they were eating, Jesus took bread, and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. He took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will not drink again of the fruit of this vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Let us pray. Father, our minds go back to that moment of time about 2,000 years ago when Christ is gathered around that table with the disciples. And as the table is being cleared of the Passover meal, this Passover lamb himself takes the elements from the table and in type and shadow points them not to the Exodus story of Egypt, but to the Exodus story of sin where he'd be leaving this world on a cross. And that the wine is his blood and the bread is his body, prefigured there in the elements of the table, reminding them of what was to happen the next day. Father, then our minds go forward a bit in time to the next day about sunrise, when Christ, hanging upon the cross, shouts out, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? And the weight of the sin, of the wrath of God poured out upon him as a propitiation for my sin, dying in my place, that all those rams and bulls and goats before were prefiguring this moment of time when Christ would take upon himself the actual sins of those who had come to him in faith. And now, Father, as we take these elements this morning, we look back in time to that first table of the supper and to the moment of the cross the next day. And see, this bread represents the body of Christ broken for us, pierced through his side, flogged, scourged, crown of thorns pressed upon his brow, beard plucked out, punched in the face, whipped with a cat of nine tails. That his blood flowed free. Father, remind us, the Bible says, with the shedding of blood, there's no remission, no putting away of sin, that Christ gave himself for us, that we could have the hope of heaven. For it is in Christ that we pray. Amen. Would you guys pass out the bread, if you would? Go ahead and take the bread at this time. Let us pray. Father, we observe this ordinance of the church to remind us that in a very real way, Christ took upon himself our sin. Remind us that we don't ever take this supper alone. We take it with the church first. And the promise of the Holy Spirit is very real in our lives. Father, we take it as you're very present with us, not in the elements, but in the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit. Father, we'll never understand what Christ meant to be forsaken by you until we see ourselves for who we truly are, vile, wretched sinners in need of a Savior. That he became sin who knew no sin, that we could become the righteousness of God. It's in Christ we pray. Amen. This time you can take the wine. Let us pray. Father, remind us that every step that Christ took from the place of the flogging to the cross was a blood-soaked step. That the Christ who was hung upon the cross was almost unrecognizable as he left that flogging, was nailed to cross beams. The passerbyers who mocked him that day, the thief on the cross, and the crowds that came by, and the Pharisees mocking him that day, not knowing what he was doing, how he was dying in the place of those. The moment he hung on that cross, the Old Testament sacrificial system of 1,500 years passed away in a moment of a few hours on a Friday. As Christ paid for sin forever. For the gift of your Son, we can never do enough to show appreciation for that. And so, Father, as we close out this service, we just offer you thanks. For it is in Christ's name we pray. Amen. The Bible says when they had sung a hymn, they went out. So as our custom at the church, we're going to start singing the first and last verse, Amazing Grace. And I'll start the exodus from the church and start singing. We'll get the first and last verse.
Let's all stand.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind. But now I see, when we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the then we